Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship at Pilgrim Lutheran Church and School on the 21st of March. We are 1 week away from Holy Week.
Woo!
Next week is Palm Sunday, but this week is also important because we live into the opportunity to get to know Jesus, who is leading us to a time of deep renewal and faith and even joy. And so welcome, everyone, as we continue on our Lenten journey, finding your spiritual center. We welcome you as you worship with us on YouTube or Facebook. Please like or share or subscribe, whatever the case may be, because we are a community of good news. And does the world need some good news?
Amen. Yes.
Yes, the world needs some good news. And so as you'll hear in the gospel today, word spreads in various ways through different connections and relationships to experience Jesus. So with that, take a deep breath and let us continue our worship celebration. We begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O holy wisdom and love.
Without your leading, we merely wander. Teach us to walk, fit our feet for the way of purpose, our minds for trusting your voice. You who shape and shepherd the many multiverses, shepherd us. In your mercy, Most High, Holy One, we pray. Amen.
Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him,
Sir, we are Greek, but we heard of this amazing Jewish guy named Jesus. Can we see him?
Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus.
What is this again?
Hi, Greeks. Did you bring me some baklava? How about a gyro sandwich?
No, maybe next time. So what are you doing here in Jerusalem?
The hour hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor.
Jesus also said to them,
now my soul is troubled. And what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name.
Wait a minute, did he just start talking to God right now?
I don't know. I'm not really sure.
Then a voice came from heaven.
I have glorified it. I will glorify it again.
The crowd standing there heard it and said,
Whoa! I guess he really was praying.
Hey, that was thunder.
No, an angel has spoken to him. Wow, this guy's got a direct connection.
Jesus answered, the voice is come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself.
He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. He will draw all people to himself? Well, I don't know about everybody else, but he has definitely drawn me in today.
Yeah, us too.
The Gospel of the Lord.
All right, so without further ado, I bring on our wonderful seminarian, Daphne. Welcome, Daphne.
Good morning, girls and boys. In the gospel today, Jesus tells the disciples a story about a seed. He speaks specifically about a grain of wheat. Jesus tells the disciples that a seed cannot do what it is supposed to do unless the seed stops being a grain and grows into a plant. And you know what? Living as a plant sounds much better than living as a tiny grain. Because a plant can offer things the seed cannot, like shelter, shade, and food. A plant can even give more seeds. And Jesus is talking about the seed dying to explain his own death and resurrection. Jesus is going to die, and he's going to rise from death. The first lesson for today is Jesus is comparing himself with a seed that turned into a plant. As a seed turning into a plant can keep growing and having new seeds, Jesus will rise from death and he will keep spreading love, healing, and peace in the world. Now, the second lesson for today is Jesus wants us to become seeds turning into plants, giving fruit, shadow, and shelter to others, and sharing God's news with everyone. And if we choose to accept Jesus' invitation to follow him, then we also can turn into plants. We also can be part of Jesus' new and better life and be able to share Jesus' love with others. So today, the invitation is, let's follow Jesus. Let's keep learning from his teachings and let's keep growing into plants so that we can become big, big plants spreading Jesus' love in the world. Amen.
Amen.
The first lesson is from Jeremiah, the 31st chapter. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, "Know the Lord," for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. The word of the Lord.
The second lesson is from 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter. And even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. The God of this age has blinded the minds of unbelievers so that they cannot see the light of the gospel that displays the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For what we preach is not ourselves, but Jesus Christ as Lord, and ourselves as your servants, for Jesus' sake. For God, who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," made his light shine in our hearts to give us the light of the knowledge of God's glory displayed in the face of Christ. The word of the Lord.
In the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus,
Return to the Lord your God, for God is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. Return to the Lord your God, for God is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love.
The Gospel of John, chapter 12. Now, there were some Greeks among those who went up to worship at the festival. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, with a request. Sir, they said, we would like to see Jesus. Philip went to tell Andrew. Andrew and Philip in turn told Jesus. Jesus replied, the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed. But if it dies, it produces many seeds. Anyone who loves their life will lose it, while anyone who hates their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, my servant also will be. My Father will honor the one who serves me. Now my soul is troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it was for this very reason I came to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified and I will glorify it again. The crowd that was there and heard it said it had thundered. Others said an angel had spoken to him. Jesus said, this voice was for your benefit, not mine. Now is the time for judgment on this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to show the kind of death he was going to die. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Good morning, Pilgrim. Thank you for joining us. Today is the fifth Sunday of Lent, and I invite you to reflect in the reading of the Gospel for today in John chapter 12. During this Lent 2021, we have been reflecting about Christian discipleship, exploring what following Jesus means for our current time, and how we can fulfill the task of being disciples by working, exploring, and understanding other contexts in the city. Our Bible study sessions, Building Discipleship from Different Voices, have been an interesting experience where we have intended to learn more about Jesus' ministry, as well as from the everyday lives and ministries of people living in other sides of the city. We have reflected how Jesus' ministry was a movement full of emancipatory decisions and actions, and how making disciples was an essential part of his liberating practice, and how he, Jesus, invited and led his followers to be disciples from a perspective of justice, love, and commitment with God's mission in the world. In John chapter 12, after being anointed at Bethany and entering Jerusalem as a king, Jesus predicts his own death and resurrection in verse 24. He says, very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed. But if it dies, it produces many seeds. And he adds in verse 31 through 33. Now is the time for judgment on this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to show the kind of death he was going to die. Some scholars suggest the Gospel of John was written for a multi-ethnic community composed by Jews, Samaritans, and Gentiles. When Jesus predicts his own death and resurrection and tells the parable of the grain of wheat, he is speaking to a diverse community, to people from different origins and cultures, from different ethnics, each one with their own customs and traditions. In the Gospel of John, we find Jesus interacting with all this diversity of people, healing and teaching them. And now, in chapter 12, we read how Jesus finds the opportunity to tell them what is to come. Jesus announces the two most important events for us as Christians: his own death and resurrection, and ending and a new beginning in the life of the world. In the text, the Greeks' desire to see Jesus is a signal that Jesus' public ministry on earth was finished. Jesus had done all that a life in human form could do, and now his hour had come. Like a grain of wheat, he must be willing to die and be buried. Jesus uses this parable to talk about who he's looking for: people with a commitment with God's mission in the world. He says, anyone who loves their life will lose it, while anyone who hates their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Jesus is looking for empowered followers who willingly give their lives to serve God and to spread God's message of love and justice among everyone. And Jesus is looking for these followers among a diverse, multi-ethnic community composed by Jews, Samaritans, and Gentiles. Jesus doesn't care about the color of the skin, nor the language, nor the social status of those followers who he is looking for. He only wants from them a real commitment with salvation, liberation, equality, and happiness for all human beings. In verse 31, Jesus says, now the ruler of this world will be driven out. One way to interpret the Greek word John uses here for ruler, orkon, is the powers and principalities of the world. Then Jesus is saying, now is the time for judgment on this world. Now the powers and principalities of the world will be driven out. Jesus is saying the system in place in the multi-ethnic community of his time, the Roman Empire, has to be driven out, has to die, has to come to an end in order to welcome everyone into a new beginning of love, liberation, and justice. Jesus is denouncing an unfair and cruel system, and he is inviting us to don't be afraid to be like him and name out loud the powers and principalities of our society that need be driven out today. Jesus is inviting us to lose our lives, giving up our privileges, building a model of discipleship grounded in justice, liberation, and happiness for everyone. Jesus is inviting us to build discipleship from an authentic desire for equality and inclusion of all people in our churches and society, never mind their race, ethnic, or culture. Because following Jesus means to learn from his emancipatory actions and decisions and doing the same. For courage to carry out this mission, he says in verse 26, my Father will honor the one who serves me. May God help us. Amen.
Sing with us and join the actions as well we've learned in chapel.
Lord, let my heart be good soil, open to the seed of your word. Lord, let my heart be good soil, where love can grow and peace is understood. When my heart is hard, break the stone away. When my heart is cold, warm it with the day. When my heart is lost, lead me on your way. Lord, let my heart, Lord, let my heart be good soil. Lord, let my heart be good soil. Open to the seed of your word. Lord, let my heart be good soil, where love can grow and peace is understood. When my heart is hard, break the stone away. When my heart is cold, warm it with the day. When my heart is lost, lead me on your way. Lord, let my heart, Lord, let my heart be good soil. Lord, let my heart be good soil. Open to the seed of your word. Lord, let my heart be good soil, where love can grow and peace is understood. When my heart is hard, break the stone away. When my heart is closed, warm it with the day. When my heart is lost, lead me on your way. Lord, let my heart, Lord, let my heart, Lord, let my heart be good soil.
Blessed be the Lord, our healer, whose voice is upon the waters, whose mercy is poured out upon all people, whose goodness cascades over all creation. Amen. Amen. Let us confess our sin, trusting the abundant grace of God. Together, reconciling God, holy God,
you search us and know us. We are acquainted with all our ways. You confess that our hearts are burdened by sin, our own sins, and the broken systems that bind us. We turn inward, failing to follow your outward way of love. We exploit the earth and its resources and fail to consider generations to come. Forgive us, gracious God, for all we have done and left undone. Amen.
How vast is God's grace! through the power and the promise of Christ Jesus, our sins are washed away and we are claimed as God's own beloved. Lay your burdens down and walk free. Amen.
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 Proud immigrant. My parents left Sri Lanka as it was entering civil war, a country once known as the Pearl of the Indian Ocean. My parents, like many minority Tamils, were desperate to protect our family. So when my mother's oldest brother left Sri Lanka for America, the hope was that he would help the rest of the family flee. So my uncle submitted an application for my mother, but time passed and we heard nothing. As their desperation grew, my parents sought refuge wherever they could find it. Nigeria was the only country that would take us. We had our bags packed and plane tickets in hand when miraculously, and truly it felt like a miracle, our U.S. application was approved. My parents brought me to this country when I was just 9 months. They came with no jobs, just $200 in their pockets, and two very young kids in their arms. We arrived as strangers on foreign soil and were welcomed by the community in our new hometown of Baltimore. It was then that the meaning of Matthew 25 took on a very personal meaning to me. For I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. Neighbors treated us as friends and eventually family. The superintendent of the Baltimore City Public Schools, where my dad got a job, found us our basement apartment. The vice principal of my dad's school helped us move in and vouched for my parents so that they could open a bank account. That warm welcome gave my parents the opportunity to plant roots, to become educators, and opened a path for me to stand here, even virtually, before you today. I went from that basement to Yale, to Oxford, and eventually to the White House as policy director for First Lady Michelle Obama. And today I sit before you as the only female CEO of a refugee resettlement agency. I have a beautiful 3-year-old daughter named Alana. You may have been hearing her screaming just a few moments ago. And I know that her life will be easier because my own parents' lives were hard. And to me, that is the American dream. The United States gave my family hope. And despite everything we face today, that hope is still very much alive. And together, we can transform that hope into change. Thank you.
We are so inspired by all the ways God is moving in and through and around this community. And it has been amazing how God has blessed Pilgrim in this time, especially as we are finding our spiritual center and welcoming new people to faith and experience God's love and grace. We rely on the generosity of God moving through the Pilgrim community. So thank you to everyone who's been giving of their time, talent, and yes, their treasure. We encourage you to make a special love offering in honor of Holy Week and for what's coming up as we anticipate Easter joy. And so let us pray together. Faithful God, you walk beside us in desert places, and you meet us in our hunger with bread from heaven. Accompany us in this meal that we may pass over from death to life with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the world and for the ways God is working through the church. O living word, you refresh us in worship and empower us to give witness among all peoples and nations on earth. Open our eyes and hearts so that we may both cherish traditional ways and new ways to share your word with the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Creating God, you fill the earth from tiny grains of wheat to the mighty thunder with your presence and calls us to attend to your will for all creation. Grant weather that prepares the soil for seeds. Protect all from violent storms, flooding, and wildfires. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of the nations, you promised to write your law on our hearts. Guide citizens throughout the world to shape communities that reflect your mercy, justice, and peace, and give them creativity to work for the welfare of all. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. O God of health and hope, thank you. You sustain us with your bountiful spirit. And Lord, every time we feel lonely, unforgivable, every time we need healing in mind or and body, you are the one who restores our joy and our health. Lord, we thank you right now that you are the health and the strength for all the people we name in our hearts and out loud as a church. We pray for George, Melissa, Bob, Sue, Rolf, and family, Rosemary, Bonnie, Karen, Gerald, Tommy, Lisa, Ken, Peggy, Chris, and for everyone caring, for anyone who is sick or dying, and for everyone we name before you now in love, silently or out loud.
Joanna, Cindy Kendall, Mary Newtons,
Phyllis Arlen, Hannah, Sean, Mark. Hear us, we know you hear us, O God. Your mercy is great.
In the cross of Christ, your name is glorified. We praise you for those we have known and are now in your presence. We pray for those who mourn, especially the Grubison family and the passing of Christopher, the Asai Kato family and the passing of Naomi, the Ramos family on the passing of Carmen, and the Hoteri family on the passing of Diane. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy and abounding in your hope made possible through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Welcome to the announcements portion of our service. We are so thankful that we've had so many people participating in our life groups and will be meeting full on this coming week as well. The only thing is that we are not going to be doing the Zoom meetings this week for the Pray As You Go. It'll just be on your own. So we encourage you to continue to go to prayasyougo.org on your own at whatever time you'd like, or to download the app on Android or Apple.
It's free.
It is free, yeah. And it's wonderful. So here's the link for finding all the different groups and when they meet. And so thankful for all the energy that's been happening. And next week is Palm Sunday. Yeah. Come here at 10:30 a.m. and we're going to process around the block, spaced out, and then have a short in-person communion service. And then also on Easter, there is a sign up for two services at 9 a.m. and 10:30. And we're also looking for people who can serve to help those services happen, to help welcome people and set up and so on. So please sign up either to come or to help for Easter Sunday in person. Let's do it. And we'll start outdoors just to make sure we're starting safe.
Darkened many days and lay. dead has been. Love is come again, like wheat on rising green. In the grave they laid him, love by hatred slain. They inked that he would never wake again. Laid in the earth, like grain that sleeps unseen. Love is come again, like wheat on rising green. Forth he came at Easter, like the risen grain. He lay there for 3 days in the grave and lay. Raised from the dead, my living Lord is seen. Love is come again, like wheat on rising green. When our hearts are wintry, grieving or in pain, your touch can call us back to life again. With all our hearts that dead and bare have been, love is come again like wheat on rising green.
We welcome you to the table with the elements that God has provided in your home, bread and wine or grape juice, any drink that will help us in a tactile way experience the love, the forgiveness, the invitation, and the new start that we all receive this morning. For we have come to see Jesus. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and all places give thanks to God, who comes to be with us and creates opportunities for friendship and connection and for life-changing service. Amen. And so with the church on earth, and the hosts of heaven, with the saints of every time and place, we remember the night in which our Lord Jesus was betrayed. He took the bread, he gave thanks, he broke it, and gave it for all to eat, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." This is the body of Christ given for you.
Amen. Amen.
And again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, and poured it out for all to drink, saying, "Take and drink this cup as the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me."
Amen.
The blood of Christ shed for you.
Amen. Jesus loves you, and nothing can change that. He is the strength of your life.
Now let us pray the prayer our Lord Jesus teaches us to pray, each in our own way and language.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Go in peace. Share the good news.
Thanks be to God.